One day, a royal messenger arrived to inform the local winemakers that the king of the country had heard of their worthy achievements and was interested in traveling to this town for a wine tasting experience of his own. The people were honored by this upcoming visit, which would increase their fame and appeal to the world. They were excited for the opportunities the royal visit would create. The townspeople gathered to discuss how to best honor the king during his future visit. They decided that their best gesture would be to gift the king with a giant wine barrel, filled with their finest wines. The king would bring the barrel back to his palace and enjoy their produce for many years to come.
How would they succeed in filling such a large barrel? Simple. Every citizen had to bring one flask of his best wine. The collection of thousands of flasks would easily fill the barrel to the brim. A giant barrel was constructed and set up in the center of the town with a ladder that ascended to the opening at the top. Over the next few days, thousands of residents lined up with their flasks, climbed the ladder, and poured in their wine.
The barrels filled in advance of the king's arrival. The locals were excited to pay their respects to the king with this fabulous gift. When the king arrived, he was led to the center of the town, eager to taste the exquisite wine which he had heard so much about.
The royal goblet was filled as the crowd waited with bated breath. Journalists were gathered to capture the special moment for the world. As the king took a sip, he made a face of utter confusion. This wasn't what he expected at all. What was going on? His drink tasted like pure water. Why was his goblet filled with plain water?
As it turned out, each person had thought to himself, why should I waste a treasured flask of wine? Surely it would not make a difference if I filled my flask with water and poured it into the barrel. The water would mix with all the wine, and no one would know the difference. It wasn't just one person who had thought this. Everybody in the town had the exact same idea. Why must I contribute my best? My small contribution would not even be noticed.
Unfortunately, an event that could have brought much fame, honor, and greatness to the town turned out to be a source of widespread shame and embarrassment. The people had failed to bring forth their best. The people had let down their royal and beloved guest.
The story we just shared with you highlights the importance of personal responsibility. As Bat Mitzvah girls, we now formally step into our responsibility to share our light with the world. Hashem created each of us unique with a special mission of spreading our own light in the world.
What does the word Bat Mitzvah mean? Bat means daughter and mitzvah means connection. We accept our role to continue the tradition of Torah and mitzvot, which has been passed down from mother to daughter for centuries, and we strive to strengthen our connection to Hashem, the Torah, and each other.
No one has a double of themselves. We each bring our best flavors to the world in a way that no one else possibly could. We should never feel that we have no special flavor of our own, for that is simply not true. No one can single-handedly take care of the entire world either. We all need to do our best, be our best, give our best and try our best to make this world a better place.
Today we will each share with you a personal message on bringing goodness to the world and on working together to achieve this goal. We will also share details on our exciting Chesed project and what we did this year to better the lives of others.
The message of 2021 is twofold. The number one at the end of 2021 represents the power of one individual and the personal responsibility everyone holds. It also represents the power of coming together as one and our deepened understanding of just how much we need each other. With unity and appreciation of others, we can all bring out the best in each other.
Oh, Welcome to the Linksfield Shul Bat Mitzvah Ceremony 2021. We will now hear from each of today's Bat Mitzvah girls.
The Talmud says that a person's true character is made up of three parts. His cup, meaning his behavior. His pocket, meaning his financial dealings, and his anger. We learn from this that how you act shows who you are as a human being. People often judge each other by their actions and seldom by their words. We all know the idiom, actions speak louder than words. And we all know that actions shows people's true colors, but actions can also shape your character. The world today needs fewer words and more action. This, to me, is the most important challenge of our time. The pandemic in which we find ourselves has shown us that each of us is responsible for making a difference. I believe the easiest way to make a difference is through chesed. Kindness is not optional in Judaism. Reaching out is an important part of making the world a better place. And being kind is central to what it means to be a Jew. Kindness can also extend to animals. My Chesed project was given to animals. I want to make a difference to animals in need of shelter and care. I learned was to do the right thing because that is the way I want to live.
Kol Yisrael Arivim Ze Laze. All Jews are responsible for one another. An important and meaningful phrase you'll often hear in the Jewish world. It means caring and helping each other in difficult times. Even when we, ourselves, are in difficult times, we can always protect, help, and understand each other. During our Chesed projects, I've learned to always be grateful for what we have and help people when they are in difficult times, just like the quote. In the Torah, a lot of the times the Jews united and helped and saved people, as well as now, recently. In South Africa, the Jewish community united to help fellow community members get vaccinated from COVID-19. A lot of people would be in danger of COVID if the Jewish community didn't help. The Jews also united as a team when our past generation of family members suffered persecution, horrors, and loss from wartime. Yet they showed resilience, unity, and kindness. This has given us Batty girls the opportunity to pass these human qualities and life lessons to future generations. Another important life lesson we can learn is when Am Yisrael stood at Mount Sinai to receive the Torah, there was a high level of unity and they said, Na'aseh v'nishma, we will do and we will listen. This means we must act right away and then listen afterwards. By doing acts of kindness, we make Hashem happy and the charity or person happy. Even if it's as easy as donating 5 rand, giving a blanket to an animal shelter, or simply giving someone a compliment. Your act of kindness matters and makes a huge difference. We can change the world one act of kindness at a time. Yeah.
A little kindness goes a long way. Acts of kindness are greater than charity since they can be done for both rich and poor. What you do affects the whole world. Let me tell you a story. Last year when my mom was in hospital, most of the Jewish community, most of which I don't know, came together to help me through a terrible time. They did challah breaks, bought meals, and prayed for a full recovery. My best friend made me forget about everything that was going on. You never know how a simple act of kindness can have a massive impact on someone. Right now, we can heal the world by being safe and responsible, but we can also heal the world by helping someone get through the day because we showed kindness. Kindness, one of the greatest gifts you can bestow upon another. If someone is in need, lend them a helping hand. Do not wait for a thank you. True kindness lies within the act of giving, without the expectation of something in return. Kindness costs nothing but means everything.
Though the last 2 years have been difficult, they have opened my eyes to who my true friends are as they stuck by my side. Even in the hard times, we learn things that we never thought of before. I know many people have gone through hard times, like losing loved ones or having to isolate from friends and family that are sick. I had that experience when my mom had COVID. At the time, my dad was here visiting from London. We couldn't see him as much as planned, but my parents encouraged me and showed me how to get over the bump in the road. My mom is my role model, my rock, who I rely on most of my life. I've had to learn to also rely more on myself. I'm thankful for everything my mom has done for me, for she's been a wonderful inspiration, and I wouldn't be who I am without her. She has taught me right from wrong, good from bad, and everything in between. COVID brought me and my brother closer than ever, which I'm sure many people are grateful for as we fought a lot. Although I wish for the world to go back to normal, whatever normal is, this time has showed me a new normal with better relationships. I searched a lot for the right quote and settled on the following. Ryan Osuku Satoru once said, "Alone you are a drop, together we are an ocean. We are better together than apart." In the Torah, when Israel split into two, they failed and were conquered. If they were still together, the outcome could have been different. It just shows that being united is always better than being divided. Thank you, Dad, for coming from London. I'm so grateful you are here. It wouldn't be a celebration without you. Thank you for listening.
Kindness. Kindness is the most valuable thing, as someone once said. To be kind is more important than to be right. Many times what people need is not a brilliant mind that speaks, but a special heart that listens. Despite our differences, we are one nation, a Jewish and a democratic nation. As we know, during these very difficult times of the pandemic, many people have unfortunately lost their jobs, and the results are that they are starving. My friends and I decided we wanted to give the less fortunate people sandwiches, oranges, and cards. By doing this, show that a one small act of kindness can have a positive effect and change their day. The world is based on 3 things, on Torah, on the service of God, and upon acts of loving kindness. Kindness is an optional in Judaism. Reaching out to others is a key part of making the world a better place. Being kind is an integral to what it means to be a Jew. By doing one small act of kindness can change someone's day and life.
The Torah speaks about Avraham Avinu and his main midah, which was chesed, loving kindness. Avraham ran to invite people into his home despite being in recovery from his brit milah. This act of chesed encourages me that I will always love to invite people into my home. I want to bring kindness into the world because the world needs some help during these hard times. It is important to make a difference in the world because, as Mark Twain says, kindness is the language which the deaf can hear and the blind can see. The 14th Dalai Lama says, "Be kind whenever possible. It is always possible. Let's change the world one act of kindness at a time." People often say, "Others will remember you not through gifts or money, but by how you made them feel." Kindness can make everyone feel better and special. Isn't that a great way to be remembered by making people feel good by just being kind?
One day, when my dad was running with a group of friends, they came across a house that was sadly burning down. Instead of walking away and forgetting about it, they risked their own safety for people they didn't even know by going in and saving some of the family's sentimental belongings. Our sages teach us, Kol Yisrael Arevim Ze LaZeh. All Jews are responsible for one another. But how can we be expected to carry such a burden? The word Arevim can also be translated as sweet. When we view each other as sweet and only focus on another's goodness and sweetness, then it is not a burden at all, but rather a privilege and a joy. This has really inspired me to be like my dad. Because of my bat mitzvah, I now feel even more obligated to do more mitzvot and chesed. The Bati program has also inspired me to embrace the Jewish woman inside of me and to be myself. I've also learned that even when it's hard, I must try to be kind to everyone, whether I'm friends with them or not. Thank you.
I've chosen to talk about kindness and how it can change the world. Kindness starts within being. Kind to oneself, family, and friends is so important. I believe that one of my unique characteristics is that I have a soft heart and I'm kind and caring to all those around me. Time spent with family and friends means so much to me. In our world today, where everyone is going through pain and heartache and people are struggling, kindness could change the world. I am told by my parents that I worry about those near and dear to me more than I worry about myself. Kindness in Hebrew is chesed. Chesed means giving oneself unconditionally with love and compassion. If we as individuals give ourselves and show some kindness to everyone, this world would be a better place. I'm blessed to have a sister who, when I grew up, was always kind, caring, and loving towards me, as well as my parents, grandparents, cousins, and friends. Sometimes it takes only one act of kindness and caring to change a person's life. Kindness is spreading sunshine into people's life regardless of the weather. I'm so grateful that I had the opportunity to share my kindness with those people at Yad Aharon for my bat mitzvah. Our time at Yad Aharon taught me that giving up some of our own time to help others is a mitzvah. While at Yad Aharon, we assisted in packing boxes and making soup for those who needed most. Thank you, Yad Aaron, for allowing us to have this privilege. And I'll always carry on being kind and caring to those around me.
United, Zoom, WhatsApp, and many more. This year we have had some Zoom and physical classes. Being united is when you go to school and help people grow, teaching whatever you know to them. One thing I've learned is that there's a lot of love in the world. Some people describe me as kind, caring, and helpful. In any situation, I'm the one who's trying to help. Aaron was known for his love for others and helping Jews out. He always tried to help in times of trouble. He was known as the peacemaker. Batty lesson is about learning new things, learning that what it's like to be a woman. Being kind isn't just helping people, for example, giving tzedakah or giving a less fortunate person money. I hope to learn from Aaron and try to be a peacemaker and spread love everywhere I go. We are united with love and caring.
Good day. How are we all united? Well, good question. I know you actually didn't ask, but anyway. Today we are all united because we are all here to celebrate our bat mitzvah ceremony. I've met some kind girls at this batty club and they all welcomed me in their group like I was the new kid in their school. All of us girls came to the Linksfield batty club this year to celebrate that we are all becoming a young woman, have responsibilities, and have more mitzvahs. As we reach our bat mitzvah, we become responsible for our own actions. But we are all united more than that. We're all Jewish, and even though we're all different, we are united because we believe in Hashem. We all left Mitzrayim and crossed the Yam Suf. As my dad says, we were all Red Sea pedestrians. We all went to Har Sinai, got the Torah, and accepted Hashem as our God. And we came together into the Promised Land, where we built a community and served Hashem in the Beit HaMikdash. Even though we don't have the Beit HaMikdash anymore, we're still united. In the words of the late Rabbi Jonathan Sacks, all that is necessary to achieve Ahavot Yisrael is to remember daily that Hashem loves us, all of us together, despite our differences, failures, failings, and disagreements. Hashem loves and forgives. Let us love and forgive.
Kindness to me is the most important quality a person can have. The word kindness means learning someone your strength instead of reminding them of their weaknesses. The world would be so different if everyone was kind to each other. We can still make the world a better place to live in if we all become kind. Being kind is not a hard thing to do. You can do the simplest thing for someone, and that is being kind. Because you never know, sometimes being kind could save someone's life. I've chosen the quote, "We carry with us as human beings not the capacity to be kind, but the very choice of kindness." This quote suggests that every single person on this earth has the ability to be kind, but you just need to choose kindness. The reason I'm so passionate about kindness is because I have felt kindness from others, and I can see how kind the Jewish community is. This makes me very proud to be Jewish. Kindness is what makes humans humane. At dark times, kindness becomes a light that will help you get through the hard times. Sometimes people think being kind is being weak. This is not the case. Kindness takes courage, and a lot of it. Being kind doesn't mean saying yes to every favor someone asks you. It simply means opening your eyes and seeing the problems others face and giving them a helping hand. Kindness has no religion, no gender, no race. Kindness is meant for everyone. Kindness is caring for others even when they may not care for you.
Alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. This quote tells us that it is so important to unite together as one, especially during this difficult time in the pandemic. That is why everyone's contributions are valuable enough, whether it be chesed, a good deed, compassion, kindness, or a smile. These are the elements that will unite us. When the Ten Commandments were given on Mount Sinai to the Jewish people, they were there to unite as one. Because of this unity, miraculous things have and will happen. The Bati program has shown me that chesed has a very important place in Judaism. When my group united to collect items for an animal shelter that would be distributed to the townships, I truly felt the power of chesed. I knew I made a difference to Hashem's defenseless animals who don't have a voice. As we have just celebrated Sukkot, which means the joy of giving, we unite together when we sit in a sukkah. We celebrate the triumph of life and enjoy the quality of family. The Bati program has inspired me through learning more about Judaism, being a strong woman, and the gift of unity. I hope I will continue this legacy of chesed in my life forever.
What does oneness mean to me? In Hebrew, the word unity is yachad, and one of its meanings is to be unified as a community in action. Jewish communities are known for creating a sense of belonging, whether they are in Israel or anywhere else in the world. As part of my bat mitzvah program, I, together with a group of friends, decided to take part in the Chesed project by helping at Yad Aron and Markle. It was wonderful coming together to assist in their soup kitchen, cutting the vegetables and helping to feed many Jewish families in our community. I felt a sense of pride to be able to make a difference in someone else's life. Life is precious and it is important to feel a part of a group. My Bat Mitzvah group has given me a sense of unity and oneness. The final goal of all religions is to realize the essential oneness. I feel blessed to have been able to share this special day with my friends and family.
Wow. Thank you to each of today's Bat Mitzvah girls. For your special and meaningful words, we've heard from each girl about what the power of one means to them, the power of one individual, and the power of one community. So I'd like to just speak to you girls for a minute. In Pirkei Avot, Ethics of Our Fathers, Hillel, this great sage Hillel, very famously said, "Im ein ani li, mi li." If I am not for myself, who will be for me? Right now, at this very moment, it is your bat mitzvah. And I would like you to think about this message. If I'm not for myself, who will be for me? I have to take responsibility for myself going forward. I have to take responsibility for my decisions, for my choices, for my actions, for my friends, for my Judaism. If I'm not for myself, who will be for me? The power of one, the power of each of you. The verse then goes on, Hillel went on to say, "But if I'm only for myself, what am I?" We're not here just to take responsibility for ourselves. We're here to take responsibility for each other, to take responsibility for the community, to take responsibility for those in need. This is the power of one community, one world, one nation, one Jewish people. And then Hillel ends the verse with, and if not now, when? Now is the time. Not tomorrow, not in 10 years, not when I'm grown up. Now, every single day, we always have the opportunity to make a difference. A big difference, a small difference in someone's life. Now is the time to take action. And I hope that this is a message, girls, that will stick with you going forward into your journey as Jewish women. If I'm not for myself, who will be for me? If I'm only for myself, what am I? And if not now, when? And I think that this is a message that all the girls have started to embrace this year with Chesed projects that some of them spoke about already. And so we're going to see a short presentation of the wonderful Chesed that the girls have done this year for their bat mitzvah.
For the less fortunate people. We have made 50 sandwiches each. We have handed them out and we are so grateful we have had the opportunity to give.
Just by doing one small act of kindness, we have brought a smile to everyone's face.
I swear I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup.
Hi, my name's Cara.
Hi, I'm Tyler.
Hi, I'm Kristen.
And I'm Hades.
And this is our
Chesed
project!
I'm Tyler.
And what are you doing in the park?
We're picking up rubbish.
For what?
Chesed project.
Oh, what's it for?
Oh, for a bati.
You can see so far we've been picking up cigarettes, plastic and everything like that. So on to Kristen.
Oh,
No words. Well done, girls. We're moving on in our program to a very special moment. We want to invite the parents to bless their daughters while the choir sings the words of the traditional prayer of parents to their children. Please have in mind your hopes, your dreams, your wishes, and everything that you want to bestow upon your daughter in this special moment. Can I ask the parents to please rise as they bless their daughters? Can I ask you girls to please rise as you receive this blessing from your parents? You will find the words on the cards in front of you.
ago, I was a tiny pink candle in your arms. Today I celebrate with beauty and charm. My bat mitzvah ceremony, it's 2021, and I want to thank you for all that I've become. You've been there for me no matter what, and gave me so much more than what you got. Your unconditional love is my greatest gift, something that will forever give me a lift. You taught me to take responsibility, to share with others and create unity. The years you teach me taught, but the days went on, as you guided me to know right from wrong. Today marks a new phase in my journey, continue my growth and discovery. And not just follow the crowd. I know I can do it when push comes to shove, because from you I have a foundation of love.
Can we get an incredible round of applause? Girls, please be seated. I can imagine that each of your parents, grandparents, those here and those online and all family and friends are so proud of you, as you guys should be so proud of yourselves. That was extremely emotional to watch you guys, and the authenticity, it just felt so real, what each and every one of you spoke. And what I found so interesting is that almost pretty much every one of you spoke in one way or another about kindness. Probably heard the word kindness today about 100 times. And that's so true. And I want to remind you girls that kindness, first and foremost, begins at home. I want you to remember this moment when each of you approached your parents or your grandparents, when each one of you think about the love in this room. Each one of you, the 13 of you, are surrounded by so much love. But you know what happens to teenagers, girls? One day you wake up and you realize that mom and dad don't necessarily love you, right? And they're just crazy. And they don't get you. And you could say a mean thing or two. You could slam a door. Or you could just hurt a relationship. And I want you to remember this moment. Kindness begins at home. To appreciate that even when there's difficult moments, when maybe our parents don't understand us or we don't understand them, maybe the home is a little tense and it's not comfortable, to always hold on to kindness. That yes, It is beautiful to see the kindness that you guys brought for those less fortunate, for the animals, and for all the people of this country in your own unique way. But kindness begins, and it's tested the most at home. And you know what? If you can look back in a few years' time and say that as you were a growing girl, adolescent, teenager, you went through high school, and you kept your dignity, you had a great relationship with mom and dad, with your grandparents, with your siblings, then you know that kindness has truly, truly entered you. Remember this feeling of love that each one of you surrounded with. Even if your parents won't be able to say it, know that they love you. Know that everyone around here loves you. And know that Yiddishkeit, Judaism, embraces you. Even when you guys go on your own journeys, each one of you is going to end up in their own place in this world, your own career, your own interests. Remember, you're sitting right now in front of Aaron Kodesh, in front of a holy ark. There are 8 Torahs right behind you. This is your home. These are your people. I hope you remember this moment. Mazel tov.
Thank you so much, Rabbi Avtson, for your meaningful words. This event wouldn't have been possible without the most amazing team behind it, and I want to give a quick word of thanks. I want to thank my co-program director, Jordi Savitz. I couldn't have asked for anyone better to work with in the bat mitzvah ceremony teaching these girls. I want to thank Maxine for being the most amazing assistant and running the most incredible Bati service on Friday nights, which these girls love to attend. Wayne Marks, our very dedicated chairman, for being so proactive in getting things to run smoothly. We could not have done this without you. Thank you to Craig Sushard, our shul president, for all the planning and logistics. Thank you to Lauren Fox for all the behind-the-scenes efforts. Thank you to Ian Bessarabia for the live streaming, to Ilan Siegel for the sound, Alon Cohen for photography. You guys are a dream team to work with. Thank you. Thank you to our amazing cousin Shmuley Brill and the Linksfield Shul Choir for the magical sound of your music. Thank you to our parents, our girls' parents, our group parents. You've been very positive and supportive, and we appreciate that. And thank you to you girls for being your best and shining so beautifully today. We will now present each one of you with a personal certificate and gift. We have prepared the most magnificent candlesticks for you to use on Friday nights. It's got your name on it. You will find it wrapped up nicely inside. Please walk down the middle. Sienna Haifa. Mazel tov. To Sky Slatsky.
Mazel tov, Sky. Indiana Marks. Mazel tov, Indy. Shayna Adler. Mazel tov, Shayna. Carly Pollack. Mazel tov, Carly. Jamie Cross. Mazel tov, Jamie. Sienna Hirschman. Excellent, mazel tov. Gabi Becker. Mazel tov, Gabi. Kira Romberg. Mazel tov, Kira. Ava Camberg. Mazel tov, Ava. Sarah Saki. Mazel tov, Sarah. Kylie Lichter. Mazel tov, Kaylee. Rachel Engelberg. Mazel tov, Rachel. We are going to miss every one of you. You have learned well, you have had fun, and you've been amazing. Mazel tov.
Everybody.
For joining. We hope the Nachas lasts forever. Please refrain from congregating in the foyer for your own safety. Please go straight to the parking area. Thank you.
Toda lecha, toda lecha.